Hello, Mary Meath. So I want to review a book, and the book I want to review is this one. Llewellyn's 2020 Witches Spell-A-Day Almanac. I get this book each year, and this year I have actually decided to follow the book, basically doing the spell that it describes each day. Now, like I've said with a lot of these Llewellyn books, I really hate the word almanac for them because they really aren't almanacs. Basically, an almanac is something that you can imagine you could use to keep track of the year and write things down in. As you can see, this isn't for writing things down in, it's just filled with information on spells. Basically, you get... I can show you. You have a page with some handy dandy icons that basically marks the days. An introduction. Then you have a little bit, one affair with some magical information about the year. This is for what sort of types of spells will be fitting throughout the year. And then each month has this introduction, which is about a page. And then the rest of them are these spells here. As you can see, they are about... they fill one half of a page, more or less. And the spells are very simple. These are definitely beginner-friendly. And most of them require very little in the way of materials. It's basically herbs and spices that you can easily get in the grocery store, as well as candles and strings and such things. I would say that most of them takes between 30 seconds and 10 minutes to do. The only one I have found here that takes longer is one that required a full circle casting. Well, that is what was recommended, so that is what I did. Though usually for a simple spell like that, I would have just done it straight up and not bother with the circle, and then we would be back to the 30 seconds to 10 minutes ratio. And there's spells of all sorts of things. What can be very nice with following this book through the year, I found, well, so far it's only been a month, but you get my point, is that it follows the energies of the days, the planetary days, and also of the moon phases and the phase of the year. So it can be a very good way to magically align yourself with the energies of the year as it develops. And I have found that while I've been practicing the occult for quite some time, I find it refreshing to try these spells because I at least have a tendency to fall into a bit of a rut in that I do the same workings again and again and again because they're workings I have done before, they now work for me, or that are part of my daily routine. And while a daily routine can be very, very useful, it can also get very static. These spells then challenges me to step out of my comfort zone and try new things. And it will definitely then, especially if you're a beginner, sharpen your skills in things like working with herbs, working with chassés, making little mocha bags, well, whatever you want to call them. And I think that can be very, very useful. So far I have really enjoyed working with these spells day by day. Now there's been some days, there's been more one day, that the spell really didn't have anything to offer me. Because I've only been in one relationship and it was a basically forget your old relationship spells. So I changed it a little bit and did the same spell to basically rid myself of fear and phobias instead of a relationship to a living person. And then I think it worked very nicely. I think there's another one that's a little bit of a miss for me tomorrow. Let's just have a look at it. It's January 29th. No, the one for tomorrow is pretty okay, but there's one for Thursday, which is basically a parking space spell, and I don't drive. But I'm sure I can convert it to something. And I'm heading out to town for Saturday because I'm going at a meeting for an occult order I'm a member of, and I'm being driven there, so I might just do the spell with the hopes of getting a good parking spot for us on Saturday. But get my point. By most of the spells are pretty generic. It's things that can work for everyone. Today was a good vibe candle. I actually like that one. I might do that fairly regularly. Because it's a thing to basically just lift the vibrations of the room. There's a glamour spell. That's the first one for January 1st. Where you enchant a bit of oil that you then put in your daily soap. That just adds a little bit of an edge to your appearance. And it helps people like you better. There's a friendship spell. It's all of these things that are basically applicable for everyone. And they are simple. And a lot of them, I'm thinking, I'll do them again. Some of them, of course, are more like, yeah, I didn't really enjoy them. Well, others I find that can be very useful for other. Basically, very useful, and they are spells I might use again. And I also found that with other years, I haven't followed the book, I have definitely found spells in the book that I really enjoyed. And that's the thing with this book. It's not just for 2020. While you'll get the full, basically, use out of following the book in 2020, because the spells are adjusted to basically to the dates and the energies of that date, you can definitely pick up this book when you find it, if no matter what year it is. And the majority, basically 95% of the spells, will be just as useful then as they are now. So this is just basically a spell book. That's what it is. It's a spell book, but instead of being ordered by topic, it's ordered by date instead. So other than the basically the spells and the blurbs about the energies of a particular month, there are, let's see, something about basically what energies are to find. You can find them in the particular days, and what the lunar phases means. Astrological symbols. What your moon sign means. A glossary of magical terms, and then there are some blurbs about the authors. And a page or two for notes. And that's it. Fairly uncomplicated book. And like I've said, that these books, they usually go, they drop in price a lot about the middle of the year, at a time where it might not be so relevant to buy an almanac for that year anymore. And especially next year, you'll find these in bargain bins. And that's when they're really nice to pick up, because then you get a spellbook of a lot of simple, really nice spells. And you can get it very cheap. So if you like pre-made spells, this might be a good book for you. If you do not like pre-made spells, then that's what it is, so then it's not a book for you. So yeah. I think it's a pretty good one. It does have a little bit of the some Satan's ball sack effect to the cover. I really don't like that fake velvety feel they try to add, but it's not so bad as in some books. That is basically my only complaint. It's my review of Llewellyn's 2020 Witches Spell-A-Day Almanac. Holidays and lore, spells, rituals and meditations. Published by Llewellyn, of course, and by several authors. I hope you have enjoyed this review. Have a great day, and blessed be.